Alright guys, so in today's video, I'm going to walk you through on how to carry out spot trading on Binance accurately so you can actually turn your initial $50 into a $500 in a short period of time. Okay, so if you don't know what spot trading is a basic among all kind of trading system. It is beginner friendly. So if you are just getting started with cryptocurrency, spot trading is the best way to get started with because of its simplicity and the low level of risk involved. It is basically buying a particular asset at a lower price and selling that particular asset on a higher price on a particular exchange, okay? So this video is going to be a step-by-step in-depth tutorial on how to effectively carry out spot trading on Binance. So that way you can get the best out of it. Plus my secret strategy I'm going to be revealing so you can actually get to know when to actually buy and sell. So that way you can initially turn your $50 into a $500 within a short period of time. So if that sounds interesting to you, go ahead and click the like button for me. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will see you in the inside. Alright guys, so welcome back. So before you get to be a profitable spot trader, you must know the two major types of spot trader so you get to decide on which one of them you are actually classified under. Okay, the first type of spot trader are those that are willing to hold for a long term, like the Dogecoin millionaire. You know that already.
Sitting in this bed in the studio apartment, and I just became a millionaire.
So this type of spot traders look at the big picture often before pressing the buy button. Okay, so the big picture, like the fundamental analysis and some major factors. This type of spot traders mostly focus 90% of the time on fundamental analysis and 10% of the time on the technical analysis. The second type of spot traders, on the other hand, is what I actually call speculators. Okay, speculators are investors like us that make decisions on the price chart, whether it is time to buy or sell. This type of spot traders mostly look at the chart frequently to catch the next big or small move on the market. Okay, and they are the real reason behind bringing liquidity to the market. So that's the clear difference between the, you know, the long-term traders and the speculators. So you actually get to decide on which one you really want to do. But for me, I prefer doing the, you know, the speculators part because I'm going to make more profit than the long-term order. Okay, so now let's dive into the strategy itself. But keep in mind, if you are doing spot trading like this, you should always keep two things in mind: support and resistance. Buy at the support level if there is entry reasons on the support level, and sell at the resistance level. Okay, so that's basically what spot trading is all about: support and resistance. You need to take note of those support and resistance level so you don't actually go into the market blindly. So that's why I'm going to be going down to the trading view so we can use the, you know, the trading view to spot the support level of this particular Shiba Inu. Okay, so we can know what it's actually going to do if we can buy it right now, and it will be appreciated in the next days, like 2 days or 1 day from now. So that's why I'm going to be heading back to over now to trading view so I get to know what this coin is actually doing pretty quick. Okay, as you can see from trading view, now we are going to change this to Shiba Inu. Okay, SHIB USDT. Okay, all right now you can see we are going to use the first result shown right here. Okay, so you now to click on it. Okay guys, apparently there are two different ways you can make money as a speculator trading spot trading. Okay, the first method is actually taking advantage of the trend continuation. Okay, trend continuation will look something like this. Let's say this is an uptrend, you know, obviously this is an uptrend, price grating high, this is a high and a low and a higher high and a lower high. Okay, this is what a uptrend will look like. Okay, so if you are in an uptrend like this, this particular method is when you have been in an uptrend already. Okay, so if you have been in an uptrend, you will be taking advantage of those support level, which is this one right here. I've just drawn a line on, which is this level. You're taking advantage of this level as a support level, breaking, like if at all it has break through this resistance level. Okay, and now acted like support. So you'll be looking for entry reasons around this support level so you can take your profit at the next resistance level at the top there, which will now do the same thing like that, like that. So you are taking advantage of these levels right here so you can buy low and sell high. Okay, there are a lot of rules govern this particular method. I'll be sharing when we go further in the video. Okay, but right now I will show you the other second method that we can, you know, take advantage of those moves. The second method is what I actually call a big support level. A big support level will look something like this. Let's say we have been in a downtrend like this. For instance, if you are in a downtrend like this, to look for a big support level, you have to look back, you know, you have to look back and see if there is any level that you can use that can act like a support for the market to still push up. If I thought you have entry reason at this particular support level, entry reason, like there are a lot of buyers that are in control of that particular level. So you can actually get into the coin here and, you know, take your profit at the next resistance level, okay? But if I thought there is no entry reason here, you have to still look further down because there are a lot of big support level on the chart. So if there is no entry reason here, you look further down for the previous one, okay? For the previous one, and, you know, look for another entry reason at that zone. Okay, that's how this big support level work. We're going to be demonstrating these two example of each of these method, okay? But first, let's use this particular one because we are in a downtrend like this. So when you're in a downtrend like this, you have to be looking for a support level that will push the price upward, okay? So now let's look for a support level on the chart right now. So let's make an example with this particular level. As you can see previously, that when price came into this particular level, right here, you know, that level used to, you know, push the price upward in a very big way. So right now we are currently in an uptrend in this particular Shiba, you know. So let me show you how to actually, you know, spot this level so that when price come into that level, you have entry reasons so that, you know, the price will, you know, likely go up if you have entry reasons on that particular level, okay? So as you can see, like previously, we were in a downtrend. So let me tell you what a downtrend will look like. Now, a typical downtrend will look something like this. When we are in a downtrend, we created a low, for instance, and a high, and a lower low, and a lower high, and a lower low. The only way you can classify this one as a lower low is when we have break through that particular support level. We now turn into resistance for the trend to still continue in the downtrend, okay? This is actually a low and a high. This is actually a lower low and a lower high, okay? So you can still do the same thing, provided we have break through this particular support level right here. So this one will now be classified as a lower low, and the second one here will be classified as a higher lower high, right? Okay, so you can see what a typical downtrend will look like. Okay, so if you are in a downtrend like this, you don't focus on what will happen in the future. Okay, we are now doing prediction. If you are in a downtrend like this, what you should be first watching out for is for you to look left. Okay, look left. If there is either any big support level that price will likely come into, so that if price come into that particular support level, you'll be looking for entry reasons. Okay, so if you have entry reasons at that support level, you get to, you know, press the buy button, so the price will likely go up. Okay, so we are going to look back to see if at all there is any big support level that we can, you know, create like a zone, so that if price likely come into that level, it will, you know, use the level as a very big support for the market to still continue in an uptrend. Okay, so as you can see, when we move the price backward, we had a clear level here. This level is kind of like choppy though. We need to see a very clear movement of that level, but this level is kind of choppy. So what you should be looking out for now, so just if that level is kind of choppy, just put an horizontal line on that level first, a two horizontal line on that level that is choppy, because this is a particular level that pushed the market upward. As you can see, this particular level here, so but this level is not well pronounced, it's not well outstanding, so that you can see it's unlike this other support level, but this one is well pronounced, so it's not choppy, it's well pronounced, so you can see it clearly. But if you look like this one right here at this line that we put, it's not kind of like, you know, well outstanding. If you see something like this, what I will always advise you to do is to look backward again, so I can, you know, make some confirmation about that level. So if we push the price backward, you can see that this level was also used in the past. This particular support level, you know, it was used in the past already. Let me zoom in so I see clearly. as you can see, that label was used previously. That label right there, so you can see the label we drawn a line on, it was used previously. That's another kind of confirmation you are going to get. Okay, that's one. If we move the price forward, you can see it was also touched by this other level a little bit. That is another confirmation. And even at this one, it was also used a little bit there, and even right here, as you can see. So those are kind of like confirmation you get if you have a choppy level, a choppy level, that the level is not like well pronounced, so you can see it clearly. So this level was not really well pronounced, so that's why I go back to the previous, you know, previous chart to look for a confirmation. So that's what I always love watching out for when I'm picking zone. You have to look for the zone that at least it has been touched multiple times or three times. Okay, so that's the level right there. This is the level I'll be watching out for. This is the level that I will also be watching out for if price still come lower. Okay, let's put an horizontal line to spot that level too. This is the, you know, the, this is the, you know, the structure level. This is a support structure level that price will eventually come. And if you should look previous, like if you should look backward, you will see that price eventually came into that support level too. Yeah, you can see price eventually used as a support right there. One, if you should still move the price forward backward, you can see that price eventually came into that level and used as a support too. So this level are support level. This is the one. These are our support level that you should also point out for. You are making preparation in case price eventually come into that one. Okay, so since this level is kind of like choppy, I think we are going to put something like the line so that you can touch every of those zone. Okay, so like now we can classify from this line to this line as the zone, because the level was very choppy. So as you can see that this level was not really pronounced, but with the help of those lines, we can guide the zone properly so that we can know where the zone is currently is. Okay, so that's the zone clearly, because that zone was supported in the past already. So you can see there it was also supported also in this particular zone, this particular zone right there. Don't get confused. Okay, this particular zone right here, it was also supported. The other zone that we drawn is the other structure level, because we drawn two structure levels. So the other line, let me change the color of that line so you don't get confused. The line, let me make it yellow. This one is the second structure level that we are, you know, targeting if price will likely come into that structure level. Okay, okay, as you can see, we eventually came into that zone right there. We eventually came into that zone. Okay, so we will now be dropping down to that 1 hour chart. Okay, now drop down to the 1 hour chart, and this was clearly the level. This was clearly the level. Obviously, this was clearly the level that price gets into. So at this level, we should be watching out for chart patterns. Okay, chart pattern like the double bottom. Okay, the double bottom or like head and shoulder pattern. There are a lot of chart pattern you can, you know, choose from, so that if you see anyone from the charts, you can, you know, prepare for the market to, you know, go up. So when we eventually came into that level, let me put a horizontal line at the bottom, at the first bottom. Okay, and the wicks. Okay, and the wicks. So this was a clear double bottom right there. This particular zone that I have drawn two yellow lines on, okay, that is a clear double bottom, because price came into that level and went up and now retested that level, and you know, with green candle. Okay, that's a clear entry reason. That's double bottom right there. Okay, so if at all you've seen that double bottom, you just have to, you know, press your buy button here at that zone, That's a clear confirmation. As you can see, eventually price spike off from that zone. That's a clear confirmation. Okay, so when price spike up, you have to, you know, look for the previous resistance that you can, you know, take your profit on top there. I'll be making a video on how to take profit and, you know, stop losses on your spot trading, but for this video I'm going to be focusing on entry reasons, okay, with the zones. Okay, so if you have chart patterns on that zone, that's a clear confirmation. So I will make a video on how to, you know, how to use all these chart pattern accurately, because there are a lot of chart pattern you should be watching out for. It's not just the double bottom, there are a lot of tons of chart pattern. Okay, so I will make a video about that. Just leave it in the comment section below so I can have your entry reasons. You can buy it at the bottom of that structure level, because if you want to, you know, there are other reasons, there are other entry reasons. Another entry reason is like, you know, taking your, you know, allowing the price to break above this level before you can take the position, you know, take your buy position. But you'll be left out of a lot of profits. Okay, you'll be leaving profit down in the table. So that's why I say you should buy it at the bottom of that structure level. At the bottom of the structure level, you should be looking out for same chart pattern, like the, you know, double bottom and head and shoulder pattern. Okay, so I'll be making a video about that. So now let's dive into the other ones. The other one is actually called trend continuation. So let's step back to the 4-hour charts. So let me tell you what the trend continuation will look like. If you should classify this level, this is the level I call the last level. The last level, that's the last pullback that buyers and seller will interact with each other. That's for the trend continuation. Okay, so if you have something like this, if you have a downtrend like this, for instance, you should be watching out for this particular last level, be this last pullback, because if price likely comes into this one will just act like the trend continuation downward. But if price break through this one and retest that one is a clear reversal of the market, that the trend is still going to continue up. So you should be watching out for that level, that particular last level. I actually make a video about this also. I will leave it in the description below so that you can watch it step by step on how I actually spot this level. Okay, I'll leave the video now. I will link it down in the description below. So that's the level right there. That's the last level. That's the last pullback level. That if price break through that level, that's a clear confirmation that the buyers are in control of that particular market. So you get to buy it around here if there is entry reasons, or, you know, take your profit at the next resistance level at the top there. You can see clear. If we like did break through this last week and greater than another lower low, so you can actually classify this one right there, this one, as the next buyers and seller zone. So get that in mind. Okay, the thing is likely going to happen in a very counter trending, like a counter trend support level, the level that I told you that if price likely come into that level, it will likely reverse up. So that's the level that this reversal of the market always likely going to happen. It does not happen anyway. It is always happening in the, you know, a counter trend level, a support level, that level that pushed the market upward in a very dramatic way. Okay, so that's the level you should be watching out for. Okay, so if we push the price forward, you can see we eventually break through that level right here, as you can see obviously, and we retested that level. This is what I call trend continuation. Okay, so if we retest that level currently, this is what the Shiba Inu is doing currently. So you can see we have already reversed to the uptrend. So we break through that level and retested that level. So when you retest that level, you will step down to the 1-hour chart. Okay, I'll just put a vertical line on that zone so that you get to know that zone, so that you get to know what this actually mean. Okay, vertical line on that zone. We now step down to the 1-hour chart one more time. So we step down to the 1-hour chart. So when we step down to the 1-hour chart on that zone, you should be looking out for entry reasons. Okay, for me, this is a kind of like a medium pullback. Okay, also there are a lot of things that will happen. It's not every time it will come back and retest that zone. There are some zone that will just, you know, when they just break through like this, for instance, they will just stop here and still continue the uptrend. It's not every time that it will come back here. That's why I've created another video already on my channel that speaks about all this type of pullback, because there are three different ways that price will pull back. So you now look for entry reason, which is, you know, after you see that pullback, after you see the pullback, you put an horizontal line, okay? You put an horizontal line on the bodies of that previous doji candle, okay? You actually wait for a break of that candle. So we actually break that candle right there. So let me zoom in clearly so I see it again. So that is the doji candle there. Even as for me, if I see this doji candle, that will be a very first confirmation to me, because the doji candle means that a lot of, you know, a loss of momentum, okay? Like there are a lot of, the momentum is not strong, the downtrend is not strong, so it's about to take off. So but for the other reasons, you have to put an horizontal line on that bodies of that previous red candle. So you have to see a break of that candle. You have to see a break of that candle first as a green candle. So your position will be something like this. Your entry will be something like this. You enter at this zone right there, because that's the way the candle closed from. So you enter there. When you enter there, you take your profit at the next resistance level at the top. When we break through that level, we tested that level, and you take your position there. So you can take your position at the, you take your profit at the next resistance level there. So, but you can see what we are doing currently, that we got rejected at this level right there. So what we want to see now, we want to see either of the two things. Is that we see price break through that level and retest that level again as usual. So you get to know, take your position, your entry reasons here, so you can also take your profit at the top there. But if price does not do that and price break through this last level, if price does not break through, this is the level I want to see price break through. If price break through this last level and retest that level, that's a clear confirmation, and you have to look for entry reasons and you take your profit at the next level. So, but if at all we don't see break through this level, because this level is a resistant level, because it has been tested multiple times. You can see this level was rejected a lot of times. You can see it was rejected 1, 2 and about 3 times, okay? And about 3 times here. So when we want to see that, if I thought it will break through this level and retest that level, it will likely continue the uptrend. But if we do not retest that level, break through that level and retest that level as possible, and we come back here and we come back down here and break this last level, okay? This is the last level we don't want to see price breaking through. Okay, that's the last level right there. Okay, so that's a level that we don't want to see price break through that level. So if price break through that level, if price break through this level, that's a clear reversal of the market, that we are going to see go down, because we are going to retest and still continue downward. Okay, but if at all we break through this level and we retest that level, that's a clear confirmation to the uptrend. So that's basically what the market will do. I have a video telling you all this kind of pullback that the market will do. I've already said it in the beginning of the video, so you check the link down below so you can get to watch that video step by step, now to actually spot all these pullbacks, okay? All right, so thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.